Hi, I'm Logan. Today we're going to do an expert level GRE math problem. The topic here is combinatorics, which is often considered one of the toughest topics on the test. Give it a try, and then I'm going to come back and show you how I would solve this one. Okay, so let's dive in first to the mechanics of how combinatorics works. And remember, what combinatorics really is just counting up all the different ways that something could happen. I'm actually going to start my calculation here with quantity B, and that's because the number of two-person teams seems a little bit easier than the number of four-person teams. And I like to keep my math life easy when I can. When you're doing combinatorics, the first thing to do is make little slots for each choice you're going to make. So here, I need to pick two people, so I'm going to make two slots. What do you fill those slots with? Well, you start off with the number of options you have for each choice. So I have six options for my first player on the team. The next slot is my second choice, the second player on the team. Well, if I've already picked someone for the first player, I have five options left for my second player. And I'm going to have to multiply those to get my total number of options. Why am I multiplying? Because, you know, once I've chosen my first person, when I choose my second one, it's almost like I'm branching into like different parallel universes, multiple ways where I could have made that choice. That multiplies over to 30. And at first that makes it look like there were 30 ways I could pick my two person team. But consider this, what if my two players were named Ann and Bill, we will say. If I had Ann and Bill versus Bill and Ann, those are actually the same team, but the branching that we did counts them as two different lists. So what we need to do is divide by two, because basically every pair we just counted with our six times five got counted twice, depending on the order in which they were picked. To remove those double countings, we divide by two, and we get 15 possible teams. Awesome. I'm gonna go take the same logic to quantity A, but this time I need four slots because I'm gonna pick four people for the team. You know, same deal. I have six options for my first player. I branch into my five options for my second player. I have four people left for my third player and then three for my last player on the team. If you went ahead and multiplied that out, you would get 360 lists. Wow, it looks way bigger than quantity B so far. But remember the double counting we had to account for over here? We need to do that over here as well in quantity A. Let's say, you know, it's not just Ann and Bill now. We got a couple other people in here. We'll just call them C and D. You know, this is one possible order that they could have been picked in, but they could have also been picked in this order. A, C, D, B. You know, they could have been picked in this order. B, D, A, C, you know? How many are there? How much overcounting do I have to, you know, figure into my division here? It actually turns out that there are four factorial number of ways to order this list. And that four factorial is also the number I need to divide by because it's the factor by which we are overcounting. That's a little combinatorics problem on its own if you want to go try it, figuring out why there are four factorial options for ordering this list. Four factorial itself, here, let me separate my work here a little bit. Four factorial is 4 times 3 times 2, that's 24. So I divide by 24. And 360 divided by 24 happens to be 15. 15 options for picking my four-person team, 15 options for picking my two-person team. The answer is C. The two quantities are equal. Okay, now, if you're wondering, well, how could that be? Shouldn't there be way more options for picking the four-person team? Think of it this way. When you're picking the four-person team, you're actually also picking the two-person team that didn't make the team. When you're picking the two-person team, you're actually also picking the four-person team that didn't make the original team. So either way, you're picking a group of four and a group of two. The only thing changing is the labels. That is why we wind up with the same number. A couple takeaways you can use on other combinatorics questions. Number one, just remember the basics, multiplying across with the number of options for each slot. And then number two, watch out for this. Watch out for occasions where you have to divide away some overcounting. It often happens when you're picking a group where each spot on the group, you know, the difference between one spot and the other doesn't really matter. Pretty tough skill, one of the harder ones on the GRE, but one to practice if you want to ace those combinatorics problems if you see them. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more of these Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep, and tell us in the comments how you solved this one.